Hello, I want to thank you from the top for clicking on this video and giving me the opportunity to tell you my thoughts about this Anker SoundCore 1 Bluetooth speaker that's going for about $20.69 on Amazon right now. This little device here that is around the same size as an 8-ounce bottle of water is the G-Project G-Zip Mini. This was my first Bluetooth speaker. The specs claim to get 15 hours of playtime, but actually it got nowhere near that. More like a third of the time that they claimed, but for its size, it packed a decent punch and didn't sound bad at all. A year later, I got the Sound Blaster Roar by Creative. This thing was packed with features: an alarm, a built-in voice recorder, a built-in MP3 player which supported AAC, SBC, APTX, and NFC support, a 3.5mm stereo input, a USB input, a USB Type-A output for power and regular USB output for power, and a micro SDHC slot. It also packed a 6,000 milliamp lithium-ion battery, which claimed to get 10 hours of battery life, but I'm not sure if it ever really got that. It was more like 6 to 7 hours. While saving the minor cons for last, it was a bit awkward to carry it around. Its dimensions are 7.9 inches wide, 2.2 inches high, and 4.5 inches deep, and weighs in at 3.9 pounds. I know I need to get into the Anker SoundCore, but this speaker is impressive. It has a 5-driver system which truly made it fill up a room with sound like you wouldn't believe. My wife liked it so much that she took it to her studio and never brought it back to our house. Honestly, I would have bought another one so I could try out the Mega Stereo feature, but unfortunately it's been discontinued. I have owned a plethora of portable sound systems and I do consider myself an audiophile. I've always had an appreciation for quality audio systems, whether it be portable, home, or car, but I never got into the ultra-loud car stereos with amplifiers and subwoofers. That all seems like a waste of money to me. I briefly had a pair of Sonos One speakers and returned them simply because they didn't hold a candle to the Creative Sound Blaster Roar. So I will say it right here and right now that I'll put the Creative Sound Blaster Roar up against any Bluetooth speaker on the market today, even the Ultimate Ear speakers, which I'll get into a little bit more in a moment. Okay, you're probably wondering when I'm going to get into the genesis of this video, which is now, so if you're interested, check out the link in the description below. Alright, moving on to the Anker SoundCore. It's not fair to compare its sound to the speaker I just previously mentioned, but I was expecting more than what I got sound-wise. I did notice that the Anker sounded better after receiving a full charge, so I highly recommend making sure the battery has a full charge before taking it out for the day. I actually have yet to experience a total loss of battery with this speaker, and I've only fully charged it once since receiving it on July 18th. FYI, as I'm finishing this post, today's date is September 21st, 2020, and I still have 50% battery life remaining. So with that said, it definitely gets to 24 hours of playtime and then some. This little box comes with two speakers inside. The louder you turn it up, the better it actually sounds. Like other Bluetooth speakers mentioned in this review, it comes with a mic, USB power port, and an auxiliary input. It's very basic. It's very compact with a rubberized shell and has excellent range. As time goes on with the Anker SoundCore, its sound has grown on me like a fungus. And I will keep telling myself, $20 for a splash-proof Bluetooth speaker with what seems to have infinite battery life is really hard to beat. One more thing, I took the SoundCore over to a friend's house for their backyard dinner. They had the Ultimate Ears Mega Boom, so we put the two speakers up against each other. As you can imagine, the UE Mega Boom won the sound challenge, hands down, but it was completely dead after what seemed like 2 hours. From there, the little Anker that could supplied us with our favorite 80s tunes for the rest of the evening. Our friends were actually impressed with the sound of the Anker SoundCore, especially considering its small form factor. So here are my final thoughts. While this isn't the best Bluetooth speaker I've heard in my life, for $20, it is. It's the best I've heard for $20. And I think that you would be hard pressed to find a better Bluetooth speaker, at least one with better battery life, for $20 that could beat this one. I just don't think you can do it. So if you're interested in buying this Anker Bluetooth SoundCore, I think it's like an A130, I'll put it in the description below. Please look at my affiliate link for this speaker. I also have an affiliate link for the new Creative Sound Blaster that they use to replace the one that I mentioned in the video. I think they're both really good speakers. I think this one is great if you are going to be out and about, you want to go to the beach or something like that, or you're just going out for the day and you want to hear your music. This is the one for you. Now, full disclosure, this one is a little bit, it's a little thin on the bass, but when it has a full charge and you turn it up, it's pretty good. It does a pretty good job. Like, I was really surprised at how well it handled, like, being outside and you being able to sonically pick out, you know, most of the instruments in a song and everything like that. So, I would recommend it. I think it's worth $20 for sure. Thank you for watching this video, and I will see you at the next review. Thank you.